Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Check out this new model. This is a deployable tent canopy. It's a model that I designed with my fan, Jack Agler, a couple weeks ago at the Marin County Fair. We had a tutoring session, and he wanted to fold a tent canopy since that's what we were folding under. And this is what we came up with in less than a half hour. It was really cool. So I'm going to show you how to fold that, and I'm also going to show you how to fold this variation that I came up with. It's a concentric square cable. I just sunk the top of the pyramid back and forth. And I want to show you this other variation that I made. This has spiral pleats. This is pretty tricky. I don't think I'm going to show you how to fold that, but I will show you these. Want to learn how to fold them? Ready, set, here goes. This model I folded out of an old wallpaper sample that I cut square. But for the purposes of this tutorial, I'm going to use a 10-inch square of Canopy. So let's begin white side up, and let's valley fold diagonally in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Okay, now let's unfold and rotate, and let's fold in half in this direction. We're making a water bomb base. So, let's fold this corner to the top. And turn over right to left. And let's fold this corner to the top. Okay, now let's open the pocket, put your hand all the way in. And let's bring these two points together and flatten. And here we have the water bomb base. Now let's fold this flap up to the top. And let's do the same with this flap. And let's rotate, and let's fold these two flaps to this point. And let's rotate again, and let's fold these two flaps to these two points. And let's unfold the two flaps and rotate. And now let's fold this flap up so that this corner touches this crease, and the fold should terminate right here. Well, actually, it should originate right here. And let's fold it up to about here. So we don't really need to fold this part. If you folded it, it's okay. You'll just end up with some extra creases. So there we have it, like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. So bring the flap up so that the corner touches the crease, and make the fold from here to this point. Okay, and let's unfold the two flaps, and let's unfold these flaps, and unfold here. So we're back to the water bomb base. And now let's fold this flap up right on this crease. So we're just extending the fold all the way, like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. Now let's turn over and let's repeat on this side, but we don't need to do all of those pre-creases. Let's just fold this flap up and we can align it with this edge. And same thing on this side. Okay, now let's unfold these two flaps and let's rotate. And now we're going to reverse fold this flap. So let's open it up and we're going to push it in. So it's just gonna go in like that, but it's having trouble. And the reason is because we need to reverse the crease. That's why it's called a reverse fold. So here's a valley. You see it looks like a valley. And we're going to make it into a mountain. So let's get your pinchers out and pinch right from here so that it's like a ridge. And the ridge goes all the way to this point. Make sure to stay on the existing crease. And now, let's try to push it in again. Now we just push it in like this, and close it back up. So it's like that. So I'm gonna show you how it was. It was like this, and we just pushed it in and closed it back up. And that's the reverse fold. Okay, let's do the reverse fold on this side. So, let's reverse the crease all the way to this point. And push it in. And bring these two edges together. Okay, so we got the reverse folds. And now let's turn over and we're going to do the same thing on this side. So unfold the two flaps and reverse fold them. Okay, now let's fold this front flap so that this edge aligns with this edge. And actually you can go a little bit further by maybe a half a millimeter. And you can see that you're going further by lifting up this flap. Or you can look at it from this side and you see it's just a tiny bit past. Okay. So it's like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. And let's turn over and do the same thing on this side. Make sure to go just a hair past. And here. Okay, now let's rotate. And let's fold this whole flap up right on these two points. like that. And unfold. And let's unfold these two flaps. And let's turn over like this. And let's unfold these two flaps. And now we're going to open here, and we're going to fold this edge inside. So it just goes inside, and let's remake these folds. So it's like that, and remake this fold. Okay, and let's flatten. And when you flatten it, you make two folds there and there. Okay, so we have it like this. Let's rotate. And now let's fold the big flap up on this line. And unfold. And let's turn over top to bottom. And let's do the same thing on this side. So open this up and fold this inside. And let's fold here and fold here. It just happened naturally because we're just folding right along the creases. And it's flattened. Okay, so that's what it should look like. And now let's fold this flap to the left and turn over right to left, and let's fold this flap to the left. And now let's fold this edge to here. We're just going to repeat the same sort of thing and fold this edge to here. Oh, make sure to go past the line a little bit. I'm gonna alter that one. Okay. And let's unfold them and bring this edge inside. Okay, and let's turn over again, and let's fold this edge to here, or a hair past it. And fold this edge to here, or a hair past. And unfold. Fold this flap inside and flatten. Okay, so we're almost done. Well, sort of. Now let's bring this down. You don't need to actually flatten it, just bring it down about like that. So this stays just curved, not folded. And now let's fold this edge to the crease. And when you do that, I'm gonna zoom in. When you do that, press down here so that the layers don't shift too much. And let's fold it up to right here. And let's do the same thing with this single flap. Fold this edge to the middle. And once again, press down so that the layers don't shift. Okay, and now let's close it back up like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. So open it, and let's fold this edge to the crease. fold it down. And let's fold this edge to here. Fold it down. And close it back up. Okay, let's turn over right to left and repeat on this side. Okay, now we're really almost done. Let's rotate and let's fold this flap up right on these two points. Unfold and turn over, and let's fold it up again, just reversing this crease. And unfold, and now we're ready to deploy. So let's open it up, put your fingers inside here, and here we have Canopy tent. And it stands. That's the action. No, there is a little action. If you pull these two points apart, then these two points clap. And when you pull these two points apart, these two points clap. So they're like pinchers.
And it also flattens. And it deploys. And it can be used at a picnic to put shade on a little bowl of fruits, perhaps. Or if you fold it extra big, it could even provide shade for you. You'd have to fold from really strong paper.
You could also bend these legs to make it a walking canopy. But if you don't want to do that, if you want to keep your model clean, then there you have it.
All right, so it's like this, and it walks or bounces along. And it can also dance like that. And there it is. So if you like it like this, then you're done. But if you want to pleat sink the top of the pyramid so that you end up with a table, then I'm gonna show you how to do that now. So here goes. Let's collapse it. And let's flatten out the legs, pretend like we never bent them in the first place.
And let's rotate, and let's fold this corner to this intersection point, right there. And let's turn over, and let's fold this edge to this crease. And you can let the bottom point swing out. Okay, and let's fold this point to here. Okay, now let's unfold the flap. And let's fold this corner to here one more time. So we have all valley folds. And unfold. And now let's turn over and let's make this fold right here. And let's bring it up to this crease. And flatten it. And when we flatten it, you see we make a new fold in between. And let's make this fold. And bring it up to here. And let's make this fold and bring it up to here too. And you can fold the little corner up. And turn over and let's fold this whole thing up like that.
Okay, so let's rotate. And here we have all of the folds. Let's unfold this flap. And now we're going to pleat sink on the fold. So let's open the pyramid canopy up. Ooh, that's kind of cool, just like this. And we're going to get out our pinchers and let's pinch along this crease right here, rather this fold. It goes all the way around. And we're just pushing the pyramid down. And so we just made this square of mountains, and in doing so, we kind of made a valley fold. We can make that valley fold a little bit stronger by just pinching the paper like this. Make sure that this edge aligns with this crease. And when you flatten it, that makes the valley fold. And just go around like that. Okay, so we have our mountain and our valley, and now we just need to repeat that until we get to the center. So let's work on this crease right here. So pinch, pinch, pinch. This piece. And just continue. Okay, now we're at the last one, which is the smallest and the most difficult. I'm basically gonna just say good luck, but watch up close. Here's the crease. Pinch right there, and pinch right here, and here, and here, and it looks really messy right now, but hopefully it'll be able to be cleaned up. And now we have our little scrunched tiny pyramid in there, and with my hand working on the bottom, I'm going to try to revive that pyramid. Okay, not perfect, but good enough. Now just shape it so that you're happy with all of the pleats. Sure, I'm happy. Okay, there it is, and from the inside, what it looks like. You might want to fix up any folds that don't look sharp enough. And there you have it. But the reason why I want to straighten them is to show you this cool thing. You go like this, and you can make the flaps actually pass each other by bending them more down like this. So they actually pass like that. And then you can make these two flaps pass like that. And this thing up here, that in math is called a hyperbolic paraboloid, or otherwise known as a saddle. Like this, like a horse's saddle. I like the look of this when the two flaps are crossed. It looks kind of like an animal of some sort with a really long nose. But anyway, I like that. I think that's pretty cool. And it's a nice table. All right, there you have it. And now I am going to square you. Bye-bye.